Homemade Battery by Jalen Stewart,
Violeta Contreras,
and Naya Slavinia
from Quintesson Academy 4th grade.
The purpose of this experiment was to see if we could power a 1.5-volt motor using household items to create a battery. We became interested in the subject after Jalen's project last year, where she was able to power a small clock using a lemon. This information learned from this experiment could be used on a larger scale to help produce power in emergencies or disasters.
Here are some notes that we need to do to make sure the car works. Make sure strips are coming up the sides.
Make sure the foil is covering the bottom of the cup.
Make sure the paper towel is covering the foil completely.
Put 2.5 millimeters of salt water from a 10 millimeter squirter.
Put 1 spoonful of activated carbon on a paper towel.
Stack cups neatly.
Make sure the strips that are coming up the sides do not touch the foil in the other cups.
We switched from the citrus car to the salt water car because the lemon juice was not giving off electricity to power the car. Even though it gave off high voltage, it didn't work because the car
the citrus
currents were bumpy. So we did some research and tried salt water and carbon.
The lemon battery produced the highest voltage at 13.23, but yet it did not power the motor.
The salt water battery produced 5.4 voltage and was able to power the motor.
The salt water battery had enough energy to power the motor attached to a small homemade toy car.
Here is our chart, which the light blue is salt water and the dark blue is lemon juice. In test one, you could see that the light blue is way higher than the dark blue because the lemon juice is way lower because you can't see it at all. In test two, the lemon juice was way higher than the salt water because it went super high. And test three, the salt water was higher than the lemon juice. And in test four, the salt water was way higher than lower than the lemon juice.
So in conclusion, we were surprised to learn that the lemon battery does not have enough energy to power the motor and move the car. Although the lemon battery was higher than the salt water battery, the lemon did not power the motor. The salt water battery did generate enough power to activate the motor and move the car. Because of our results, we wonder why the high-voltage lemon battery did not power the motor. If we were to conduct the science fair project again, we would try researching electric motors and how they work, as well as electrical currents. That's our science project.